This is Match Game 74, production number 0161, air date to be announced, VTR 216-74, take one. Get ready to match the star, Orson Dean, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Marianne Mobley, Richard Dawson, and Betty White, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Raymer.
Is the upper tier okay?
Oh, just fair.
The lower tier is okay.
And you and Brett buy your hair at the same place. I think it's adorable.
Thank you for noticing. Speaking of bodies.
Oh, hiya. Nice to have you back again.
Thank you. It's just nice to be back.
I'll just touch a little bit. Is that all right?
Oh, those are the fringe benefits for being on the show.
That's right. We deducted from the check.
Let's say hello to our current champ. Current champ.
Here's Donald Boyd.
Hello, Donald Boyd. How are you?
Pretty good.
He doesn't have much money, but he's got a lot of spirit. He's only got $100. He's won one game. And you're going to start with the audience match and have a go at the big money, over $5,000, right?
Yeah.
You ready for that?
Uh-huh.
Okay, we're going to get to that right after we get to this message of interest to one and all concerned. Hey, here we go with our current champ, Donald Boyd. He's won the game. And now he's going to have a go at the big money super match here in which he can win over $5,000. Ready, Don?
I'm ready.
Here we go. We polled a recent studio audience. We got their best response to this. Turtle blank.
Aww.
Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match that answer. If you match a second one, it's $250. If you match a third, it's $100. A little help from the audience. Whom would you like to choose?
Okay, Brett.
Brett is one. How do you fill in that blank?
I'm going to say, I'm torn between two answers. I'm going to say turtle dove.
Turtle dove. A lovely thought. Turtle dove is one.
Richard.
Richard is number two.
Yeah, something that Brett has, a turtleneck.
Turtleneck. She's not wearing it today.
No.
One more.
And Charles.
Something that Brett can cook, turtle soup.
Turtle soup. Okay. So you have turtle dove, turtle soup, and turtleneck. You may choose one of those as the answer or think up one of your own and give it, but we call for an answer now. What do you say?
Turtle dove.
You say turtle dove. The audience is undecided whether that's going to be a winner or a loser, but we're all going to find out together right now. It's Brett's answer. We're looking for turtle dove.
You have to keep saying that over and over again, Jay.
May we see the $100 response?
No.
Turtle soup is up there. That's one that Charles gave you. All right, that may be a good omen or maybe a bad omen. Who knows? We're still looking for turtle dove. May we see the $250 response? Turtle neck is up there. Well, Don, that's two out of three. What do you think?
You got it.
Let's pull the thing.
Hey, let's pull the thing and get it over with and find out. All right, here we go. For the $500 response, go.
Turtle.
I can't. Turtle wax. Did anybody think of that?
No.
Did you think of that?
Yeah.
Where were you when we needed you? Well, Donald, you've got $100. I'm sorry you struck out here, but you're still the champ, and you're going to play another game, and you may strike out next time again, too. So let's meet another player. Here comes Linda Malloy. Linda, you know Donald Boy? How are you?
I'm fine.
You look like a very happy, well-adjusted lady.
I'm very happy.
Are you happy and well-adjusted?
Yes, very well adjusted.
Good. You want to tell us something else about yourself?
Yes, I moved out here from Dallas, Texas. I've been in Los Angeles for a couple months now, and I'm trying to get together a composite and be a photographic model.
You're trying to do that?
Yes, in the big city.
I'm taking some pictures tomorrow afternoon.
Oh. No.
Don't try to cut down.
No. Don't go to his place for your pictures.
No? Okay.
Come to my place for your pictures. Well, good luck to Linda and to Donald, and we'll begin by pushing this button here, revealing two questions, and ask Linda, our challenger, to make a selection.
I'll take B, please.
She wants B. We ask you to make the selection, Linda, because some contestants find some questions harder than others, and we leave it up to you entirely. Everybody plays. When Bob touched the light switch while standing on the wet tub, his blank lit up. Turn around and write something there that we can show and tell a little bit later. All right? Bob touched the light switch while standing in the wet tub. His blank lit up. Orson's the first one finished.
No, I'm the last.
Oh, you're the second. Hey, Orson. All right. Come on, Charles. Waiting. Now we're set. Linda Malloy, we put it squarely up to you. When Bob touched the light switch while standing in the wet tub, his blank lit up. What do you put in that blank?
His nose.
His nose lit up. Okay. Larson, she said his nose lit up.
Yes, and luckily, Bob was standing on a short stool, so indeed it was his nose.
His nose.
He'd been on a taller stool.
Yeah, all right. That's enough of that. Brad?
I want the man with the buzzer to be terribly, terribly careful. You don't want my wrath on your head. His whole head, which does include his nose.
No, no, can't, no, sorry. But it includes his ears and eyes and all that.
Would you hand me my bullwhip, please?
No. Charles Nelson Reilly.
I got four of them, Linda, so I said his eyes lit up.
His eyes lit up. All right, nose is the one that Linda's looking for, and we call on Mary Ann.
Well, I'm a little worried, because Charles and I think the same, and
right,
I said his eyes.
His eyes.
So you look
Charles
the same,
is okay.
Too.
You know you don't look the same.
How much taller?
Richard.
Yeah, Linda.
God will punish.
I thought we'd take the pictures about, 2 o'clock. Nothing gaudy, no.
No. Wear something simple, yes. Bring several changes. Brett, Betty.
Brett, yes, you're sure all you gentlemen are art directors. His eyes lit up, what Charles has four of.
Okay, so that's two for you, and Donna, we'll get to your question in a moment or so, but first we've got to do this for you, and here it is. Here we go with the completion of round one. A question for Donald Boyd. Everybody plays, and this is it, folks. Yes. In the middle of the night,
yes,
when no one was looking,
yes,
Jane ate Tarzan's blank. Let's sit up straight here.
Do I dare?
No, you can't. Hold on, wait a minute. I just gotta look at it there. It's my show. I can look at it if I want to.
But it's my card.
Oh, all right. All right, everybody ready over here is okay. Now, Donald, in the middle of the night, when no one was looking, Jane ate Tarzan's blank.
Banana.
She ate his banana in the middle of the night.
Yes.
What do you say to that?
I think that if Donald hadn't said it, the crowd could have turned surly very easily. I ever saw a popular decision. He had a wrestle cheated to the ground for it, but he did eat Tarzan's banana.
Okay. Brett?
Yes, dear.
Would you show us your card, my dear?
Oh, I'd love to. I was
it's time.
Thinking about fruit and peppercorns and things like that. I said, loincloth. He'd hung it on a tree.
Jane ate Tarzan's loincloth.
Yeah, she was a cloth freak.
I see. Okay, I guess she was pretty hungry, too, Charles.
If she's a cloth freak, where does that leave you? Moving on. No, Yule Gibbons would have said vine.
Vine. You would have said, eight is vine. Now, are you ready to show and tell, Mary Ann?
Suddenly, it's not. She ate his vine.
His vine. Okay.
And his vines have been tender grapes.
Not a lot of nourishment in there. That's right. Richard?
What is it, Richard?
Richard.
I beg your pardon? Those quick naps are marvelous. Yeah. I happen to know that Jane did eat that particular piece of fruit and then departed. Hence the expression, banana split.
I see.
Okay.
All right. Hello,
oh,
Betty, how
hi,
are you?
Jane, I'm fine. Look.
Yes.
No, now, would I lead you down the garden path?
Yes, you would.
She ate, well, I would, but I didn't this time. She ate his banana.
Okay. The score is 3-2 at this moment in favor of the current champ, and we'll go to round two and ask Linda to make a decision.
A, please.
A, here we go. Last time, Linda, you matched Orson and Richard, so the two of you gentlemen will not participate. Murray asked his wife why she had a bag of garlic hanging around her neck, and she said to keep blank away. Kind of long, I better do it again for you. Murray asked his wife why she had a bag of garlic hanging around her neck, and she said to keep blank away. All right, everybody's ready up here, and I guess we're all set down here. Okay. Now, Linda, Murray asked his wife why she had a bag of garlic around her neck, and she said, to keep blank away.
To keep you away.
You.
Yeah.
Keep you. She didn't want him hanging around.
That's right.
Keep who away? You.
Murray. You. Her
That's
answer
you
is
and you.
You and you.
You and you. And Yule Gibbons.
How about you?
But not me.
But not you.
I said to keep colds away.
To keep colds away.
It's
That's...
an old... No.
That's right. It's an old European remedy.
Welcome to Transylvania.
Yeah, that's right.
You're gonna miss
Charles.
I say your mother away.
To keep your mother away.
Mother was not
no match there. What did you say, my dear?
Well, everyone knows it's to keep evil spirits away.
Evil spirits. Uh-oh, Linda. We're getting close to the end here. You must match Betty to stay in the game. Betty.
Everyone knows it's to keep you away.
You. As we go to the second half of our second and final round, I point out to Donald, one match for you will win the game, and here it is. When Gunga Rama left India, he built...
Gunga Rama. Dummy, Gunga Rama.
You all know Gunga Rama.
Cinerama's sister.
That's right.
That wasn't even a good one.
Anyway, when Gunga Rama left India, he built a special suitcase so he could bring along his blank.
What? I'm with you.
I'll read it for the audience. Now listen carefully, audience. I don't want these what's coming up here. When Gunga Rama left India, he built a special suitcase so he could bring along his blank.
What?
You're not too bright, are you, there? All right, everybody ready over here. Let's see, it's just Brett, Charles, and...
Oh, you don't write.
Oh,
you don't
Marianne. Okay. Charles, ready. All right. Now, Donald, we call on you. When Gunga Rama left India, he built a special suitcase so he could bring along his blank.
A snake.
His snake. He was a faker, apparently. So, Brett, snake is the answer.
Honey, I'm trying to make up for the way I treated you before. Snake.
So, snake wins the game. You had sacred cow.
Yeah.
All right, all he needed was one to win it, and he
it's
did it. And now we've got to say goodbye to this pretty Linda Malloy and wish her the very best of luck in her modeling career. A gift waiting for you backstage. Goodbye, Linda. We'll get back to you in a moment or so, but first, we got this message we want to pass along to everybody, so stand by, okay? Well, John, you ever figure you'd be back here again?
Yeah.
You did? Okay. I'll see you around, Pam. No. Here we go again. Gonna have another go at over $5,000. We polled a recent studio audience, got their best response to this. String blank. Now, you know how it goes because we've been through it. 500, 250, and 100. Little help from the celebrities. Choose one, if you will.
Better go with Brett again.
There goes Brett again.
Oh, God, isn't he the most wonderful person that ever lived? How about string orchestra?
String orchestra.
Oh,
that's the answer. That's what she chose, and that's what we have to go along with.
And Richard?
Richard.
Well, he's just a good old boy, so I'll say string bean.
String bean. Okay.
And Betty White.
Betty White.
String along.
String along. String along.
For that one.
So you got,
that's what I meant. I meant string.
You got string along, you got string bean, you got string orchestra.
Can I change my name?
No, you can't change nothing. Too late now.
I mean string orchestra.
No. What did you mean?
String quartet.
Yes, string quartet.
Well, it's too late to change what we have to go with as your first answer. What do you want to do? You want to choose one of those or give us one of your own?
I could go with string bean.
String bean. Okay, that's the one we're looking for. We'll find out if it's up there right now. First, may we see the $100 response? String quartet. That's the one you had in mind.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Sometimes my mind does a little flip-flop.
I noticed that.
All right, we're looking for string bean. May we see the $250 response? String along is Betty's answer.
Very
if string
good.
Turtle wax comes up, I think it's going to hit you.
String turtle wax. All right, you think it's under there, audience?
We hope so.
Well, we all hope so. String bean, here is the $500 response. String bean! Congratulations. He sure is a popular winner, isn't he?
Yeah.
All right, you've got the $500. That means you're not be playing for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. Now, to collect the $5,000, you got to match one kookalook over there on a head-to-head basis. Has to be an exact match. Time to choose one now.
Oh, Richard Dawson.
Richard, you get ready to write. You face me if you would, please, sir. Here's the $5,000 question, Richard. Please write your answer to this. Oil blank. O-I-L blank. All right, he is now finished.
I'm sorry.
He is not finished.
I finished now.
Okay.
Uh-oh.
All right. Well, apparently he changed his mind at this last moment. So now we need a response from you, Donald. Oil well. Okay. For $5,000, Richard, may we see your answer? He said oil well.
See, for I put oil pump.
Oil pump?
Then I remembered, well, he's a good old boy.
From Oklahoma?
I thought, well, what could I do but right away?
Charles.
The makers of the turtle wax people call is going to get free case for life.
Well, we congratulate you, Don. We're all very happy for you. You're still a champ. You're going to need another player and see if you can increase your winnings of $5,700. Here comes Elena Weber. For him?
I'm tickled.
Sure is happy for him, isn't he?
That's great.
Well, Elena, would you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Okay. I'm from Sacramento, California, and I'm visiting my one-woman fan club who's in the audience, my mother.
Yeah.
Here. And that's it.
Okay, nice to have you with us. We'll start this game. Wish you both the best of luck in a moment or so. But first, we've got to start and finish. Listen, our time is up. And we found out all about Elena Weber. Can you remember about Elena Weber and tell us the whole thing again next time, Elena?
I hope so.
Okay, we'll look forward to seeing both of you next time. And we thank all of you for being with us. And we hope you'll join us next time.
We'll join us next time.
Are you still excited about all of those Mary Tyler Moore shows you're going to be doing? Have you started doing them yet?
No, that'll be for next season. I did 5 for this last season, and then they're on hiatus. And then we come back middle of the summer.
A regular member of the family.
She's a marvelous actress.
She really has
a handsome husband to support.
Join us next time.
Thank you. Bye. Las Vegas. Lights. Clothes. Games of chance. But behind the spectacle is a private world. The price of admission, $100,000 of your own money. It's the high-stakes room you haven't seen until now. Watch Real High Rollers Johnny Chan, Phil Hellmuth, Doyle Brunson, Daniel Negreanu, Barry Greenstein, and Jerry Buss. High-stakes poker. Monday nights at 9.
And I think the same. And
right.
I said his eyes.
So, Charles is okay, too. You know you don't look the same.
I'm much taller.
Richard.
Yeah, Linda. I thought we'd take the pictures about, 2 o'clock. Nothing gaudy, no.
Wear something simple. Yes. Bring several changes. Brett, Betty.
Brett, as you sure all you gentlemen are art directors, his eyes lit up. What Charles has 4 of.
Okay. So that's 2 for you. And Donald, we'll get to your question in a moment or so. But first, we've got to do this for you. And here it is. Here we go with the completion of round 1, a question for Donald Boyd. Everybody plays, and this is it, folks. Yes. In the middle of the night, when no one was looking, Jane ate Tarzan's blank. Let's sit up straight here.
Do I dare?
No, you can't. Hold on, wait a minute. I just gotta look at it there. It's my show. I can look at it if I want to.
But it's my card.
Oh, all right. All right, everybody ready over here is okay. Now, Donald, in the middle of the night when no one was looking, Jane ate Tarzan's blank.
Banana.
That's one that Charles gave you. All right, that may be a good omen or maybe a bad omen. Who knows? We're still looking for Turtle Dove. May we see the $250 response? Turtle Nick is up there. Well, Don, that's 2 out of 3. What do you think?
You got it.
Let's pull the thing.
Hey, let's pull the thing and get it over with and find out. All right, here we go for the $500 response. Go.
Turtle
wax. Did anybody think of that?
No.
Did you think of that?
Yeah.
Where were you when we needed you? Well, Donald, you've got $100. I'm sorry you struck out here, but you're still the champ, and you're going to play another game, and you may strike out next time again, too. So let's meet another player. Here comes Linda Malloy. Linda, you know Donald Boy? You look like a very happy, well-adjusted lady.
I'm very happy.
Are you happy and well-adjusted?
Yes, very well-adjusted.
Good. You want to tell us something else about yourself?
Yes, I moved out here from Dallas, Texas. I've been in Los Angeles for a couple months now, and I'm trying to get together a composite and be a photographic model.
You're trying to do that?
Yes, in the big city.
I'm taking some pictures tomorrow afternoon.
No. Don't go to his place for your pictures.
No? Okay.
Come to my place for your pictures. Well, good luck to Linda and to Donald, and we'll begin by pushing this button here, revealing two questions, and ask Linda, our challenger, to make a selection.
I'll take B, please.
She wants B. We ask you to make the selection, Linda, because some contestants find some questions harder than others, and we leave it up to you entirely. Everybody plays. When Bob touched the light switch while standing on the wet tub, his blank lit up. Turn around and write something there that we can show and tell a little bit later. All right? Bob touched the light switch while standing in the wet tub. His blank lit up. Orson's the first one finished.
No, I'm the last.
Oh, you're the second. Hey, Orson. All right. Come on, Charles. Waiting. Now we're set. Linda Malloy, we put it squarely up to you. When Bob touched the light switch while standing in the wet tub, his blank lit up. What do you put in that blank?
His nose.
His nose lit up. Okay. Carson, she said his nose lit up.
Yes, and luckily, Bob was standing on a short stool, so indeed it was his nose.
His nose.
He'd been on a taller stool.
Yeah, all right. That's enough of that. Brad?
Now, I want the man with the buzzer to be terribly, terribly careful. You don't want my wrath on your head. His whole head, which does include his nose.
No. No, can't. No. Sorry. But it includes his ears and eyes
Would
and all that.
Would you hand me my bullwhip, please? No.
Charles Nelson Reilly.
I got four of them, Linda, so I said his eyes lit up.
His eyes lit up. All right. Nose
Thanks
is the
mother.
One that Linda's looking for, and we call on Mary Ann.
Well, I'm a little worried, because Charles...
Start with the audience match and have a go at the big money, over $5,000, right?
Yeah.
You ready for that?
Uh-huh.
Okay, we're going to get to that right after we get to this message of interest to one and all concerned. Hey, here we go with our current champ, Donald Boyd. He's won the game, and now he's going to have a go at the big money super match here in which he can win over $5,000. Ready, Don?
I'm ready.
Here we go. We polled a recent studio audience. We got their best response to this. Turtle blank.
Aww.
Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match that answer. If you match a second one, it's $250. If you match a third, it's $100. A little help from the audience. Whom would you like to choose?
Okay, Brett.
Brett is one. How do you feel in that blank?
I'm going to say, I'm torn between two answers. I'm going to say turtle dove.
Turtle dove. A lovely thought. Turtle dove is one.
Richard.
Richard is number two.
Yeah, something that Brett has, a turtleneck.
Turtleneck. She's not wearing it today.
No.
One more.
And Charles.
Something that Brett can cook, turtle soup.
Turtle soup. Okay. So you have turtle dove, turtle soup, and turtleneck. You may choose one of those as the answer or think up one of your own and give it, but we call for an answer now. What do you say?
Turtle dove.
You say turtle dove. The audience is undecided whether that's going to be a winner or a loser, but we're all going to find out together right now. It's Brett's answer. We're looking for turtle dove.
You have to keep saying that over and over again, Jay.
May we see the $100 response?
No.
Turtle soup is up there.
This is Match Game 74, production number 0161. Air date to be announced. VTR 216-74. Take one. Get ready to match the stars. Orson Bean, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Marianne Mobley, Richard Dawson, and Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rimmer.
Is the upper tier okay?
Oh, just perfect.
The lower tier is okay.
Can you and Brett buy your hair at the same place? I think it's adorable.
Thank you for noticing. Speaking of bodies, how are you? Nice to have you back again.
Thank you. It's just nice to be back.
I'll just touch a little bit. Is that all right?
Oh, those are the fringe benefits for being on the show.
That's right. We deducted from the check. Yeah. Let's say hello to our current champ, current camp. Here is Donald Boyd. Hello, Donald Boyd. How are you?
Pretty good.
He doesn't have much money, but he's got a lot of spirit. He's only got $100. He's won one game. And you're going to start.